Racing. Whether it's on foot, with animals, by boat or plane, or to get to space, it has always been a thing that humans are quite fond of since the dawn of man. The most popular form of racing in this day and age is motorsports, dominated by our four-wheel creation, the automobile. I always knew about racing, and I liked it quite a lot. I was also really into cars, and although I wasn't born in a place where car racing was popular, I always had an affinity for them and going fast. But when I was younger, the only thing I knew about racing was Mario Kart, Need for Speed, and Fast and Furious. As I got older, I heard about sim racing many times, but I thought it was boring with the lack of drifting and over-the-top action. And it looked like people in their midlife crisis were the main audience, as they had the money to spend on all of this. Well, that changed after I saw this. This trailer is what got me into the downward spiral that is sim racing. Project Cars, a game developed by Slightly Mad Studios, shined a new light into what I thought about sim racing, as they made it look so much more fun than it seemed. Maybe this is just a testament on how good they were at making trailers. Now, they're not just known for their Project Cars series, but also for the GTR racing games and some Need for Speed titles, among other things. They came onto the world unofficially by a group of modders, with Ian Bell as one of the team leaders, and over the years they founded Blimey Games and continued development for future GTR games and such until 2008. In 2009, that is when Slightly Mad Studios was born, and in the following years while working for EA, they were responsible for the releases of games such as Need for Speed Shift and Need for Speed Shift 2 Unleashed. I don't know what exactly they were unleashing, but both of these games got decent reviews for its new take on the series, mixing realism and arcade fun, showing what SMS was excelling at. Although, user score was mostly mixed, which is one of the reasons I would say EA decided to go even more backwards with future releases. After some time in a shaky relationship, in 2011, Slightly Mad Studios announces that WMD will fund their development of a new game named Project Cars and leave them the time to finish the game without publisher pressure and deadlines. They also released games such as Test Drive Ferrari Racing Legends, Walking Dead Assault, to which I never heard of, and a few more, but their most successful title was Project Cars. After I saw the trailer and the release date of 2015, gone were the days of playing arcade racing games like Test Drive, Need for Speed, and some mobile racing games like Real Racing or Asphalt. And then came the days when I played Race Room as my first hardcore sim racing game. Somehow I never got my hands on a Gran Turismo game, even though I owned a PlayStation 3. Oh well. Maybe it's because the gameplay wasn't as over the top like Need for Speed and some other games. Anyway, when I saw the graphics and the way the game looked, the fact that there would be dynamic day and night and dynamic weather, and the promise of it being a really good simulator, I got very excited, as I wanted to be more immersed pretending to be a racing driver. I wanted the game to come out now, but then the question was, where was I going to play it? I didn't have anything that could run this game at a decent frame rate on low settings, and I was racing on a race room at 30 FPS or less with a gamepad on top of that. That didn't bother me though, because all I needed was to get a job, get some money, and buy my first wheel and gaming PC, which took some time, and I finally got it when Project Cars 2 came out. Nice. There was also the announcement of Assetto Corsa, which at the time seemed to be a bit of a step down in the visuals compared to Project Cars, but we're not here to talk about this game. Once released, the reception by the community was well received, but there has been some talk that the physics have changed a bit after the beta, and that it was not for the better. Even though hardcore sim racers said the game was still not at the level of other serious titles, and that it was more of a simcade style of racing, I didn't really care. Since I knew nothing about car handling dynamics, I thought it was enough, as it simulated tire wear, pit stops, dynamic day and weather. I thought it would still be the best racing experience out there, even though I haven't gotten my hands on it yet. But when I finally got the money, I still bought Project Cars 1, even though the next game was coming out very soon. And I played it as much as I could with the free time that I had. And I quickly found out what the reviewers were saying about the physics. And I have to say, in comparison to Race Room, The cars were definitely easier to drive, even though I was still on a gamepad. But does more difficult driving mean more realistic? And Project Cars was more friendly for gamepad users compared to Race Room. And man, it was fun. Racing in the rain and racing at night were some of my favorite moments. Comparing the drive and feel of road cars and their race-built counterparts, with that, I quickly let go of Race Room as it doesn't have any of those features. But soon after I built my first gaming setup, I was able to finally race with a wheel. And it was okay. I was also getting into the F1 games at the time, and I have to admit, it felt a little bit better with my T300. By the way, I have to say this, revisiting Project Cars for this video, but with a direct drive wheel, feels so much better than I remembered. I can actually kind of feel the movement of the car, even though sometimes it felt too light or that my tires were never warm enough. But the physics were still fun to play with. So, Project Cars was and still is a really good game when you look past its issues. But when Slightly Mad Studios announced Project Cars 2, they mentioned that the sequel would be even better in terms of simulation. With their Madness engine, they introduced realistic puddle formations, which was something completely unheard of in sim racing, and was for a long time, until GT7 introduced their take on it after 5 years. They also added snow, I guess to show the simulation capabilities of the Madness engine, but in my opinion, Project Cars 2 was definitely an improvement from their first game, as the cars felt like they had more weight, but for some reason, some cars had very strange handling characteristics. Project Cars 1 felt like the cars never had enough grip, while Project Cars 2 felt like the cars just wanted to continue to turn no matter the speed. Basically, the cars at times were too oversteering. But I found myself enjoying the physics of Project Cars 1 more somehow, even though Project Cars 2 has its moments where the racing is absolutely amazing, as the AI also was decently improved from the first game. But one feature that they added that I still absolutely love was the setup engineer if you are not very familiar with making your own setups. And I have to say, it helped me quite a lot. And although at first I couldn't tell which objectively had better force feedback, because while revisiting these games with a DD wheel, both felt pretty good, though I remember that with my CSL Elite, Project Cars 2 needed more fine-tuning to get the proper detail. And I can't forget that the community was asking for an improvement in the force feedback, the tire physics, and the curbs trying to suck you in, among many other issues, but there was complete silence until the announcement of Project Cars 3. So when Slightly Mad Studios announced that Project Cars 3 was coming out soon, I was so excited. And I was ready for a game that will improve from the previous game and finally give me an all-rounder simulation game that had all the features and more for an affordable price. But when I saw the announcement trailer, that excitement quickly faded away. From this point on, we knew that Slightly Mad Studios never really cared about the fanbase that they've amassed with the Project Cars series. And we saw that they stopped taking the acronym CARS to heart. With that realization, we also found out that Codemasters bought Slightly Mad Studios, and that they were also releasing another game, Fast and Furious Crossroads. I don't think I need to talk about that game, as we already know what happened. But I was curious to see what Codemasters are going to do with Slightly Mad Studios, now that they have their developers. And unfortunately, that was short-lived, because soon we found out that EA bought Codemasters, and with the history SMS has with EA, Ian Bell and a few others apparently left. I did a bit of digging, knowing what kind of reputation EA has with certain studios they buy only to shut them down, and found out more about the whole situation with Slightly Mad Studios. Things did not look good for the future of Slightly Mad Studios. And after this tweet, we found out that Project Cars was no longer going to be on Steam, maybe due to some licensing. But quickly after, EA cancelled future plans they had with Project Cars. I'm assuming it's due to the sales and reception of Project Cars 3, but I'm just going to say this. It's clear that EA's board don't really know anything about the racing community, and that would include arcade racing games all the way to sim racing, because they have been having trouble with the Need for Speed games for too long. Even though Need for Speed Unbound has a decently positive reception, the player count on Steam is interesting, while Forza continues to make people happy somehow. Well, not really, but because Horizon 5, well, that doesn't matter. Either way, with all that being said, and for those of us who own Project Cars, we still have the ability to revisit those games and reminisce of the good old times and the bad. But we also have Automobilista 2, which uses the same Madness engine, but this time Riza is trying to put in the effort to show us that the Madness engine is capable, and they're doing it with some decent level of success. Time will only tell, although they are releasing regular updates, and they do have big plans for the future, so here's to hoping. Oh, and we can't forget, I believe that the Madness engine still provides the best visual and performance in VR racing compared to any other titles out there. Though I have to say, somehow Automobilist 2 is somehow more demanding, while some visuals are a bit of a step down from Project Cars, aka the trees. Unless you have AC with the Soul mod and many other mods, Project Cars has everything from the start. Literally the only sim racing title, or simcade, no actually it's not the only simcade, but the only sim racing title that feels in some way complete, even though the cars can be a bit lackluster in some areas. As for EA and Codemasters, let's hope that they will use the talent of the remaining SMS developers and maybe use some features from the Madness engine or improve on the engine for future F1 titles and maybe some other games, but I'm not going to lie, I'm not very hopeful. But I pray that since Codemasters got the deal with WRC, I hope that they remain a simulation and that they continue to improve on the simulation aspects, even though they want to keep it accessible, obviously. But as long as they don't create an arcade game first and then add simulation features to it, and instead decide to do it the other way around, we should be okay. Please learn from Project Cars 3. The sim racing community is growing larger each year, and with all the companies creating sim racing gear and the exposure that is being created in real-life racing events, larger companies need to know that the market is there. We're less of a niche now, but we are still sometimes hard to please. But hey, that's enough of that. So here's to the future, and a big farewell to SMS and Project Cars. It was fun, and I will never forget how you brought me into sim racing. Thank you for watching this video. Took me a while to actually put this video together, I'm not gonna lie. And also, took me a while to put any video in my channel, let's be honest. But yeah, I've been busy and then just kept postponing some things. But if you like this video, there will be more videos being uploaded on a regular basis. And, you know, I'll try to improve the quality and all that stuff. So if you like and you want to see this channel grow and help me grow at the same time, you know, give it a like and subscribe and share to other friends you have that also fell into the hole of sim racing and just want to watch anything sim racing on YouTube. But yeah, that's that. There will be a next video uploaded about next week. I will try to keep those uploads weekly, if not more than one video a week. But yeah, there will be more, and I will see you in the next one. Goodbye.